Dear friends, welcome to second video of our science stream. After 10th grade, if the student chooses a science stream, then what are the courses that are available after 12th and how best he can select his career and what are the preferences that are there as a career options? Let us see that in this science stream with physics, chemistry, mathematics and biology, the courses that are covered in this medical stream are medicines, alternative medicine, paramedical courses, pharma, food technology, forensic science and speech and hearing. Watch this video. If you have any questions, ask under comment section. I will definitely come back to you. Now I will tell you about the one of the important course which most of the science students wish to do, that is in medicine field. So the course is MBBS. The students with the MBBS degree, the MBBS means medicine baccalaureate, chirurgie. So here that means Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Chirurgie. Chirurgie means surgery in Latin. So this is an undergraduate program. So if you do this, you can become a physician. It's a 5-year program. You can become a physician. And what you do there is you will be a doctor. It will be called as allopathic doctor. And the work of you is work as a physician, prescribe medicines and a treatment for the disease. And research while and also you can do the research and while surgeons will perform the operations. To do the surgery you should have the specialization, right? That is a normal course, right? Normally after MBBS they do the master's program MD, and after that there will be MCH. MCH means Magistri Chirurgiae, that means master of surgery, right? So that is the normal hierarchical way of doing the things in a medicinal field. So MBBS, master degree and then MCH. So this is the order, right, to do the surgery. And corresponding to MCH there is DM, doctor of medicines, for medicines for the field. And here the salary will vary between 6 to 16 lakh and all depends upon the institute from which you have graduated and also the course that you have taken, specialization that you have taken, right? So for MBBS there is a lot of demand in the country, right? And here you have to, if you got selected in the government sector, right, the government, you can have to work in the PHCs, and especially in the beginning you have to work in villages. So and for the entry for this will be through the entrance examination. After 12th you have to take the entrance examination. The examination is called as NEET, NEET, and this examination will be for the physics, chemistry and biology subjects. PCB marks will be taken, right? And so that there will be entrance on the physics, chemistry and biology subjects, right? And NEET is the entrance examination conducted. And the beauty is from 2020 onwards for all the medical colleges of India, right, starting from All India Institute of Medical Sciences in Delhi to JIPMER, which is there in Pondicherry, for all the institutes even the entrance examination is NEET. Earlier they JIPMER used to have their own examination, Vellore used to have its own examination, likewise All India Institute of Medical Sciences. Now from this year onwards, from 2020 onwards, NEET is the main examination for the selection of the candidates for MBBS course. And here most of the people feel that this is a costly course, right? No, it is not so. If you get very good marks in NEET, you can get selected in government colleges. There are many government colleges which are doing very well, and they are reputed government colleges. JIPMER is a government college, All India Institute of Medical Sciences is a government college. So if you get in that, definitely your future will be good and you can serve the community as a doctor, right? And what is the selection of process and what are the career opportunities, that I will tell you in the next slide, right? In detail I will tell you about it and what are the prospects in the different countries for the students who have done MBBS in India. That also I will give it in the next slide. Now let us go to the other medical stream. Then next is BDS, Bachelor of Dental Surgery. Right, so after this MDS is the next postgraduate course, right? And if you do this course, then you become a dentist or you can also get involved in research. So what you do is you address the dental problems and health care of the dental problems as well as the surgery, right? So this year BDS can do that, right? So this is the next stream, right? So here of course it is more specialized to the dental aspects, whereas MBBS is for the entire body of the human being. And the salary will be between 4 to 6 lakh, right? And there are quite a good number of dental colleges in India. And of course, for this also, NEET is the criteria. as the entrance examination. So these two are the very important medical course most of the students prefer to do, MBBS and then MD. And most of the people feel that MD is a very costly affair in India, but there are other institutes, other opportunities through which you can get the postgraduate course in other parts of the country or world as well. Now let us go to another important course that is less known to majority of the people, that is Bachelor of Audiology and Speech and Language Pathology, BASLP. This is a Bachelor of Audiology and Speech and Language Therapy, Speech and Language Therapy. And he will be called as, if you complete this course, you will be called as a clinical audiologist, a speech therapist and speech pathologist. So this is quite extensively, the services of speech therapist and pathologist are being extensively used in some of the Western countries, right? So what these people will do is, they learn about the normal aspects and the disorders of the speech. So these doctors, they are also called as speech and hearing doctors, and normally they are called as doctors. Actually, bachelor, master degree holders are generally called as doctors, but BASLP will also be called as doctors. And what they do is, they learn about the normal aspects and the disorders of the speech, language and hearing, the disorders in language and hearing, they train in evaluation, diagnosis and treatment and management of communication disorders with the boy or kid. There are kids who even after 3 or 4 years, they are not able to speech properly, talk properly, and the speech will have some problem, and that, and also they will be having the problem with the hearing, and that will be addressed by the students who have done BASLP. And this is one of the best course, and the number of colleges in the countries are less. And since the number of colleges are less, right, the demand for this is more. Right, there are people who are with disability in the speech, they have disability in the hearing, and for them this is one of the best course to treat those people. This is one of the best course. There are very reputed colleges in Karnataka, right? All India Institute of Speech and Hearing at Mysore is one of the best college for this course, right? So these are the three very important medicinal field, right? The clinical field or the pathology field, and that you can take up if you want to serve the community as a doctor. Now I will give you some more informations for this medicinal course, so that you can make a better decision from medical to the speech and hearing. What are the additional information that is possible from my side? I am giving it for the MBBS, right? The course, the selection of the colleges is based upon the ranking given by the National Institutional Ranking Formulations, right? Designed by the MHRD Department of Government of India, and that has designed the ranking systems on the basis of the infrastructure, student staff ratios, and more details regarding the selection of the colleges are being discussed in explaining the engineering courses. So please refer that. I have discussed in detail about how this NIRF will make the ranking, will give the ranking to the institutes, right? So on the basis of that, you can have the list, and this link will give the list of the colleges from the top ranking to the bottom one, right? So top ranking at present, it is All India Institute of Medical Sciences at AIISH, which is there in Delhi, right? So there are institutes in Bangalore with the JITMER of Pondicherry, which is at the 8th position at present as per this 2019 ranking. So likewise, there are many institutes, right? We can select accordingly, right? So this link will give the selection of the colleges, right, which is best college, so that can be easily depend on this ranking. And this will give you the what is the best options after MBBS in upcoming years, right? What are the best possibilities, what you can do after this, right? So normally after MBBS you can do MD, right? Then that is a master's program. MBBS is an undergraduate program, master's program is MD, and after that normally for surgery they do MCH, that is registry chirurgy, right? And then they are eligible as per the hierarchical order, but even MBBS and MD doctors will do the surgery in India, of course, right? And this will give you which are the best countries which will offer postgraduate course after MBBS course in India, right? Those graduates, MBBS graduate from India can look for the different countries all around the world, globe, starting from US, New Zealand, Canada. Canada is one of the best place even to pursue your career after MBBS. Canada, Australia, New Zealand, European countries, right? There are even Germany is also one of the best country. But only thing that you have to know is you should know German language perfectly, right? So then if you know that language, then it will be a very good option for the people who can pursue the medicine career and also postgraduate course in Germany. So that list can be obtained in this link. And for the BDS, right, so these are for the MBBS. Then for the Bachelor of Dental Surgery, so this will give what are the best career options after MBDS in India, that is there in this link, right? And in this link, which will be how BDS career is treated in India and what are the options, right? So that you can get it in this, more details are there. And also there are instances where the people who are taken BDS couldn't do the BDS properly, and what are the agony that they have faced also could be seen in it. So this is to give a clear picture about the course and how the students will pursue the things as per their perception. So that's how given this. This will give the what are the countries, which are the countries for the dentist with the BDS from degree from India to migrate or to pursue their career, right? So different countries do offer course, right? And this is this link will tell you about it. And here one thing which would like to tell you is especially in case of Canada, right, the people migration will be easier, but the thing is after going migrating there, they will switch over to the public health career, right? So you can get that more details in this thing. Okay, this is for the BDS. Next, for Bachelor of Audio, this is for speech and hearing, right? For this speech and language therapy pathology, right? The speech and language pathology, for this the best course college, the All India level is All India Institute of Speech and Hearing, which is there at Mysore. So this is a government organization, right? And this is considered as one of the best institutes in India. And other options, right? This link will give the list of other Bachelor of Audiology and Speech Language Pathology colleges in India. So you can apart from this, there are many institutes in Karnataka and also different parts of India. You can get it here. And then this will tell you about how much would be the salary for this graduates, right? This link will tell you about the salary that you can expect for this speech and hearing pathologist, right? And the pay scale can be obtained from this, right? This will tell you the link for the salary for this audiologist. And this will tell you about the scope of this year BSLP course in India. So these are the opportunities, and this you can definitely pursue the BASLP as an undergraduate program, and there is also you can have a chance to do the BASLP and then the PhD in this course. So these are all the options, the career options for the students in medicinal field. Now I will tell you about alternative medicines that are there that you can study after second PUC, that is after 12th. So those students who are taken science after 10th and with the combination of physics, chemistry, mathematics and biology, then opt for these courses. The courses recognized by AYUSH Department of Health. A for Ayurvedic, Y for Yunani, U for Y for Yoga, U for Yunani, S for Siddha, and H for Homeopathy. So these are all the courses which are run by the government itself, right? And of course the private institutions are also there, right? The first one is Ayurvedic Medicine, Bachelor of Ayurvedic Medicine and Surgery. And this is considered as Indian medicine, and the persons who completed this graduation program, undergraduate program, will be called as either they can take up a doctor, they can become a doctor, that is Ayurvedic doctor, or they can continue the research and do the and become a scientist, or they can also teachers, or they can also start manufacturing the Ayurvedic medicine. So these are the different careers that are possible for Ayurvedic medicine doctors. The graduates with the BAMS. What this BAMS graduates will do is, as far as the career is concerned, their role is, it is an ancient medical system that is known, as I told you, it is an Indian medical system. And what it does is, it cures and prevents the recurrences of the diseases by increasing the harmony of Kapha, Pitta and Vata. The virtues of human being is Kapha, Pitta and Vata. By balancing the harmony between these three, the recurrence of diseases will be controlled.
and for that they make use of the herbs which are there in this land, and this is considered as one of the best medicine course. And the salary for this will be between 2.5 to 4 lakh. And one thing that has been observed here in India is most of the BAMS graduates in the suburban region, the practice allopathic medicine. So there is a course in this BAMS which will deal with allopathy medicines. So normally the majority of the BAMS graduates will be practicing allopathy medicines. So that is for information, but actually they are Ayurvedic medicine doctors. Now next medicine, then next course is medical course is homeopathy medicine. So BHMS, Bachelor of Homeopathy, Homeopathic Medicine, Homeopathy and Surgery, Homeopathic Medicines and Surgery, and those graduates are called as homeopathy doctor. And here the treatment and the role of these doctors are, they treat the patients. The patients are taken care by enhancing the natural healing power of human body. So they enhance the natural healing power of the human body. In this system, body, mind and emotions are interlinked. So they consider the emotions and body, emotions of the person. And by knowing the emotions of the person, they treat the patient rather than the treating the disease. Here, it is a treatment to the patient rather than the disease. So that is the difference. And the BHMS has the origin in Germany. Henman is considered as the father of homeopathy. Next medicine is BUMS, Bachelor of Unani Medicines and Surgery, and the doctors are called as Hakims, right? So they are called as Hakims, and this is considered to be originated from Persia. And in this case, the treatment enhances that this treatment, the Unani treatment, enhances the body's natural healing power. It's quite similar to this, but by using Unani medicines. So they use the Unani medicines here, and the Unani medicines are basically again similar to the herbs which are used in Ayurvedic medicines, similar to that. So these are all the Ayush degree programs, and in this they can become the doctors, Ayurvedic doctors or homeopathy doctors or Unani doctors. So and the salary for this BEMS is between 2.5 to 3.5, and the scope of these courses are discussed in the next slide. Let us get some more information on the courses which are discussed now on Ayurvedic, Homeopathy and Unani. And as you know, Ayurvedic is an Indian medicine, and the Charaka, right, the Shushruta is considered as the father of the surgery. So it is known to the Indian medicines for a long time, and Charaka, they are the scholars, right, ancient scholars of Ayurveda are these people, right. And in this, the other career aspects, right, can be obtained from this, the details about what are the prospects for the BAMS graduates can be obtained, and not only in India and in other parts of the world, right, how it is considered. So that could be obtained from this, the detail from this link, and this will tell you about the job opportunities for the lab Ayurvedic medicines, right. This is exclusively for the Ayurvedic, and in this you can also see the journals which are there for the Ayurveda, right, and the journals which are there, and it will deal with some of the aspects of Ayurvedic medicines also. It is all about Ayurveda can be seen here, and also the manufacturers of Ayurvedic medicines, all the links you can find it in this link. And are there any scopes for the BAMS has been discussed by the graduates of BAMS, and in this link, right, we can go through it and make a selection. Next, Bachelor of Homeopathic Medicines and Surgery, and Father Henman, he is considered as the father of homeopathy, Dr. Henman, right. So this will tell you about the homeopathy medicines and what are the features of it, and this also gives the information regarding the Henman, right, who is the father of homeopathy, and whether this, what are the best options, career options for homeopathic medicines has been discussed in this link, and by the people who are the graduates in Bachelor of Homeopathy Medicine Surgery. And this also tell you about whether the chosen field, that is BHMS, is good or not. So has been discussed here, is it the selection that you have made is good or not, has been explained by one of the doctors. There are three, four doctors discussed this, right? So that you can come to know. So these are all the first hand information about the course, as these people are the graduates of this course. And also you'll come to know, this is will tell you about the career prospects and also the salary component involved in this BHMS, right? After BHMS course for them, what are the opportunities and what is the salary you can get it from this employment link or employment website shine.com. For Unani Medicine, and this will tell you about the historical background of Unani Medicines for the information, right? How it is there, right? How it has come here, right? You can get it from here. And also this will tell you whether it has value, BMS has value in the Indian context. So that you can get it from here. And and other Unani colleges which are there, that the details can be obtained from this. So these are all the additional information for Ayurvedic medicine, homeopathic medicine and Unani medicines if you are choosing this as your career, right? So if you choose BAMS, better if you know the Sanskrit, it will be more useful and you can get ample of literatures available in our ancient history, ancient books which are available, and that can throw more light into Ayurvedic medicines. Now I will tell you about other two alternative medicines which are coming under Ayush program of Government of India. And here the students who have taken a science after 10th, they can choose a medical profession after 12th. And the medical profession under Ayush are, already I have told about three, right? Other two are, one is BSMS, Bachelor of Siddha Medicines and Surgery. And this is considered as Tamil medicine. So here one of the essential criteria for a person to take up this BSMS is you should know the Tamil language. If you know the Tamil language, it will be very easy for the person to pursue this BSMS. And the person will be a doctor after completing this BSMS course, right? And it is a 5.5 years course, in fact. Okay. And in this treatment, what they say is a human body is controlled by seven elements. Saram, Chinir, Onam, Kolampu, Lumbu, Mulai, Ithriyam. So these are all the Tamil words for plasma, blood, muscle, fat, bone and semen. So these are the seven elements which will control the human body. And these seven elements are activated by three mukutram, results in disease, right? So they will be triggered by this mukutram. And these are the one which will affect, right? This variation in this will affect the elements, right? And that results in disease. And Siddha system corrects the vitiated mukutram for healthy life. So here the correction will be done by advocating the medicine. The medicine will be basically herbs and dietary control, right? That's why this is considered as older than Ayurveda by the Tamil people. That's for the claim, as per the claim. So this is the profession, the doctor profession after 12th, and this is called as BSMS, Bachelor of Siddha Medicines and Surgery. The person who completes this will be a doctor, and the salary that he can expect will be between 10 to 20,000 per month. So this is another alternative medicines that you can think of. The next one is a BNYS, Bachelor of Naturopathy and Yoga Sciences. And here, of course, this will also be a doctor, that is a profession or a career. And in this treatment, the doctor will doing this, that is, they will be controlling the diet. So there will be extensive uses of diet control and of this naturopathy. And exercise, yoga are the main component. Massage and herbal medicines are for the QA, right? So this is the course, right? This involves yoga. In yoga, Yama, Niyama and Pranayama are the three virtues of this yoga, and this can control the body and the mind, they say, right? So the controlling the body and mind is most important for the health and health of and wealthy of the person, and that is why this BNYS is picking up in most part of the world. So the person who knows yoga very well and know about naturopathy can survive in any part of the world, because this involves less amount of the medicines but more of yoga and dietary controls. So this is one of the best course as far as the Ayush is concerned, right? Under Ayush, right? And because it is, it will maintain the general health and health of the person by controlling body and mind. So
So that's why this is most important among all the five, I can say. And the salary will be between again 10 to 20,000. Again, it depends, right? That depends upon the place. In most of the metropolitan cities, right, this course is picking up to a greater extent, right? And also in other parts of the world. Now let me give some more information on Siddha and Yoga, Siddha and Yoga medicines. So Siddha, as I told you, it is, these two are the Indian medicines. In fact, this Siddha, as I told you, it is a Tamil system of old traditional medicine, and it is been developed by the sage, it seems, right? And of course, the good olden days, right? This has been used to greater extent, right? And here it is basically the herbs and are the one which will be used to control the seven elements of the body, right? And the details of all this can be obtained from this web page about the Siddha medicine, and bachelor of degree in Siddha medicines and colleges which will teach this, and what are the eligibility criteria that I already told you, and 10 plus 2, after 12 you can choose this, and also what is the expected salary in India can be get from obtained from this web link. And next is yoga, and of course before that let us know more about this also, right? BSMS, more details can be obtained from this, right? This also gives about the courses which are there in Tamil Nadu and Kerala, right? So these two will tell you about the colleges and how they teach, right? And also to a certain extent will brief you about more brief you more about the Siddha medicine. And of course yoga is the most important one in BNYS, right? That is a very important for maintenance of health and wealth of a person, right? This will control body and mind, right? This is the famous Surya Namaskara, which is the most important yogasana in yoga. And this will tell you about the career which is possible in BNYS. This will tell you about that, and then this will tell you about what are the scopes for the naturopathy and yoga in the future, right? So you have to see what will be your future, right, after completing this, right? This is being discussed by the students who have already undergone BNYS program, right? They have shared their experience in this link, and this also gives about affiliated colleges which are there in India, or what are the best colleges. Even in Karnataka there are many good number of colleges which are teaching BNYS program. So these four five are Ayush programs, right? One is Ayurveda, Siddha medicine, homeopathy, yoga, and Yunani. These are the five of Ayush programs which will facilitate the students to take up doctor profession or medicine profession. Right? Of course, these five are alternative medicines to allopathic treatment. Now I will tell you about the companions of allopathic doctor. He is a pharmacist. And for that you have to do the pharmacy program, and after 12th you can do this, and again for that you have to take science after 10th, and with the biology background it will be better. Of course, so they do take a PCM on graduates also for this pharma, but if you know biology, then it will be very easier for this course, right? I prefer PCMB rather than PCM with other subjects, because this is more related with the biological sciences, right? So it is more interdependent. If the person knows the biology, it will be more important, more good. And the courses are this, that is a B Pharma, the Bachelor of Pharmacy, right? B Pharma is Bachelor of Pharmacy. It is a 4 years course, and the career will be, you can become a pharmacist, drug therapist, food and drug inspector, right? Then you can also become analytical chemist in pharmaceutical industries, and also in the chemical industries, right? This the chemical industry will manufacture bulk drugs, right? So this is the career which you can take up after B Pharma. And what these people will do is they can do this research, right? There is a lot of scope for the research in B Pharma, and the preparation and testing of drugs, that's what they do, right? So the preparation and testing of drugs, and also formulations, right? So here the drugs in the form of a different either tablets or tonic or an injection formulation, right? That will be done by this B Pharma graduates. They are nothing but cooks to prepare the drugs, right? Actually, chemical bulk drugs will be prepared by the chemist after preparation of it. It will be made into a form of a tablet or tonic for the perfect dosage, and that will be done by B Pharma graduates. So, and they can also become medical transcriptionist. So this is another profession that you can think of. So compared to medical transcriptionist, formulation pharmacist is the one which is extensively, which has wonderful application and also the scope, right? More scope is there for the B Pharma graduates in India as well as in other parts of the world. And the salary will vary between 2 to 5 lakh per annum. And this is one of the best course that I advocate for the students who would like to do the career, which would like to pursue the career. And you can also do the doctoral degree in this. And there is another course called PharmaD. It is a doctor of pharmacy. It was a doctor of pharmacy. It is a 6-year course. Here also you can become the pharmacist. And your role will be in R&D, research and development, and formulation and development, and production, clinical research, IPR, of course, Indian, this is a patent of regulatory act. You can become an expert in it, right? And regulatory affairs so that you can take care of, sales and marketing. And also you can take up lecture. And many more possibilities are there for this doctor in pharmacy. This is PharmaD, right? B Pharma and PharmaD. So you should know the difference. And there is another course called D Pharma. The difference between D Pharma and B Pharma is D Pharma is a diploma course in pharmacy. Diploma in pharmacy. PharmaD is a doctor in pharmacy. Right? They are doctors. Doctor in pharmacy. In diploma in pharmacy is for the people who would like to. This is an entry level course. Who would like to start or open the medical stores. For them, D Pharma is quite very well essential. Nowadays, they are also preferring B Pharma. Right? And this they could be entry level pharmacists. And this is the necessary skills and academic knowledge required to for entry level positions in retail pharmacies as well as pharmaceutical companies. So especially in retail pharmacies, that is medical stores, that are could be opened only by the people who are having knowledge of this pharmacy. That is, they should have this diploma in pharmacy, then only they are allowed to open retail pharmacies. So these are all the pharma courses. I prefer from B Pharma and D Pharma for PharmaD for the people who would like to pursue their education. In fact, there are a lot of scope for this B Pharma and D Pharma, PharmaD candidates in US and other parts of the world. So this is one of the best course for the students who would like to pursue the career which is akin to medicine, right? Of course, these pharma graduates are the companions of doctors. Without these pharma graduates, in fact, medicinal field will be zero, I can say, because they are the people who will make the drugs for the therapeutic values, right, to for the treatment, right, and drugs are as necessary that are being made by these pharma graduates. Now, as I told you earlier, the role of a pharmacist is that they will make the tablets or the mixture which is necessary for the treatment. So their role is conceptualized to commercialization is done by this pharma graduate. Tablet or like there are pharmacopoeias. Indian pharmacopoeia, British pharmacopoeia, and US pharmacopoeia, and that will have a standard operating procedures, standard procedure for the making a formulation process, and by following that they do the formulations, right? So the pharmacopoeias are like a bible for this pharmacist, right? And this is Pharmacy Council of India. It's quite similar to Medical Council of India. This is the website for it, and the present president is the principal of JSS Medical Pharmacy College at Uti, Mr. Suresh. Dr. Suresh is the principal of president for the MPCI, that is Pharmacy Council of India. And what are the careers possibilities which are there in pharmacy? You've obtained from this web portal, and also how a pharmacist of an India can survive, can become a pharmacist in USA, can be obtained from this link, right? This link will tell you about if you become a B Pharma or D Pharma graduates, how you can suit to the pharmacist profession in US, right? That can be obtained from this link. And this is one of the better profession, right? And also the in terms of salary, this pays very, very good. The careers, even in UK, is also good. The career for the pharmacist in UK can be obtained in this link, right? So these are the possibilities, and also salary for these people, for the pharmacist, can be obtained from this web portal. It's a job portal. Right. So this will give an idea about the salary that can expect, that can be expected by the pharmacist after completing their either B Pharma or D Pharma. So this is one of the best course I can say for the people who would like to have a very pleasant life, a pleasant career, so to say. Now I will tell you about the paramedical courses which are there for the science students. After 10th, if you have chosen science as the course and the PCMB as the combination, we can choose this following paramedical courses. The paramedical courses are first is nursing, bachelor of nursing, and you can become a staff nurse. It doesn't mean that you need to be a female. You can also be a male, right? He or she can do this bachelor of nursing, and the career would be a staff nurse. They deals with various aspects of patient's care. Work in close contact with the doctors. They are just next to doctors, I can say. They will be taking care of the patients 24/7. So they are the most important people in keeping the health of a person with the help of the doctors. Doctors will guide the staff nurse in taking care of these patients. So they are like warriors. They are the main warriors, and with the help of the guide, that is the doctor, they take care of the health of a patient. And that is why this Bachelor of Nursing is very, very important, and it is a very, very caring profession. It takes care of the personal health of a person, right? So that is why this is most important profession. And these people are been regarded as the semi-gods, because they are the people who will always be with the patients and take care of their health. And the person who completes Bachelor of Nursing can expect a salary between 3 to 8 lakh per annum. And of course, there are cases, since the number of colleges are more, number of staff nurses are also more. So supply demand, there is a variation in supply demand, supply and demand. As a result of that, annual salary may also vary. And what will happen is most of the students will complete the Bachelor of Nursing, will migrate to different parts of the world, and they have wonderful opportunities, especially in case of Middle East. Many nurses or staff nurses are from India, and that too from Kerala. Majority are from Kerala state. Another paramedical courses, Bachelor of Physiotherapies. Right, this is picking up to a greater extent. Many colleges, new colleges, apart from the medical colleges, other colleges have also started this Bachelor of Physiotherapy, and they are called as physiotherapists. And of course, this is a paramedical course, right? And here in the physical therapy is an allied health profession. Physical therapy is an allied health profession that helps people increase, maintain, or restore the physical mobility, function, and strength. Right? If there is any, if the physical mobility of the person is affected, then normally they go for physiotherapy. Right? So for that, this course is very, very important. Physiotherapy is nothing but there will be number of exercises that can restore the physical mobility of a person or function, or that can also increase the strength of the person. So the role of physiotherapist is, physical therapy is an allied health profession that helps people increase or maintain or restore their physical mobility, function, and strength. Right. So this is the role of a physiotherapist, and in fact you can have your own physiotherapy clinic at your house itself, right? Or you can work for the hospitals, right? So this can be an independent or self-employment course, and the salary that you can expect will be between 2 to 7 lakh, and again depends upon the performance of the physiotherapist. That is most important, of course, in any profession, in paramedical profession. This personal behavior as well as how best this person can execute the service is most important. Next is BSc in renal RDT, that is renal dialysis technology. Now most of the urban populations are suffering from diabetes, right? So for them, right, many people dialysis is one of the important treatment, right? So they will be called as dialysis technician. So dialysis technician, and their role is administer hemodialysis treatments for the patients with renal failure. So if the renal filtration is not working properly, so it will be done physically, it will be done by external agency, right, by external method, and that will be done by the physio BSc RDT. Of course, this is almost like a nursing profession, but it will be a specialized for dialysis because it involves extra skill for a person to do execute this job or rather service. In fact, all these medical services courses are the paramedical courses, and they are nothing but the service given to the human being to maintain their health. So this is another course that you can take up, and the salary varies between 2.4 to 3.3 lakh. So it depends, right? It depends upon the hospital in which you are working, and also here you may have to work in shifts also, right? So there will be possibility for all these, right? Especially for nursing, this BSc in RTT, so you may have to work in shift. Now I will tell you some more paramedical information for this paramedical courses, additional informations for the nursing, renal filtration, that is dialysis, and also physiotherapy. For nursing, right, you can get more information on nursing courses and careers in this website, right, and then this also tell you about different policies and practices in the nursing, right. So these two are additional information that you can get for the nursing. And after a Bachelor of Nursing, you have different options. You need not work in the hospitals. There are 31 different career choices which are possible for the Bachelor of Nursing, nursing, and that you can get it from this link. And this link will give you different options which are there for the person who has completed the Bachelor of Nursing. There are 31 choices in the career as there for the Bachelor of Nursing. And this will tell you about the salary that you can expect after completing Bachelor of Nursing. And those who would like to pursue this nursing as their career, please read this article and also watch the video which is there at the end of this link, right? That will give a clear picture about the non-traditional jobs that are possible. I was telling you about other jobs that are possible. So this will give you an idea about the non-traditional jobs that you can pursue after completing Bachelor of Nursing. So this article has it, right? And this is about nursing, and of course you can get the certification. And there are other organizations in UK, US and other parts of the world can help this nursing profession, and they can utilize their services. So what is important for this person is he must be compassionate and caring. He or she must be compassionate and caring, and if you have that attributes, definitely you can go for Bachelor of Nursing. Next, for renal filtration, that is dialysis, right, with the help of a dialysis membrane, of course. And for that, what are the options for this dialysis technician? What are the job prospects that can be obtained from this job portal, Glassdoor? Okay, and that this link has the information on the job prospects for this dialysis or renal care personnel. And this is about the cartoon is about the role of a physiotherapist. The person who is not in a position to walk can walk by going through the treatments given by the physiotherapist. So these are the basically exercises or actions that you have to execute so as to become a mobile person, from immobility to the mobility. So the physiotherapist will play an important role. So they help you in rectifying the problems and mistakes, and corrections for your body and actions could be done, will be done by the can be taken up by the help of with the help of physiotherapist. So this is how, and what you can do after physiotherapy can be obtained from this. This will tell you about the career aspects, career prospects in UK, right? So in United Kingdom, that can be obtained from this. And also what are the options for the renal filtration, that is a dialysis technician. So these are the salaries for the dialysis technician. What are those that can be obtained from this link? And then this will tell you about the careers. So what are different careers for the physiotherapist, right? And this will give an idea about again some more information about the physiotherapist in UK, right? And then this will give an idea about the salary that you can expect for physiotherapies, right? So these are all the additional information for dialysis expert, nursing, and also physiotherapist. Now I'll tell you some more paramedical courses that are there after 12th for the students who have taken science with the PCMB as a combination. And the paramedical course is BSc in CCT, that is cardiac care technology, and it's also called as cardiovascular technology. And these people will be called as cardiovascular technologists, or they can also choose a lectureship, that is, they can be the teachers in the medical colleges. The role of this BSc CCT guys are, they understanding of detailed diagnostic and therapeutic procedures that involve the use of complex tools, machines, and pharmacological agents, right? So the tools and machines all will be well utilized by these people for in the treatment and the therapeutic diagnostic and therapeutic procedures that are involved in the treatment of the persons who are suffering from cardiac problems. So in, for the cardiologist, these people will become a helping personnel. They can take care of the machines that can keep the health and wealth of the heart. And for that, these people, the BSc in the cardiac care or cardiovascular technologist, becomes very, very handy to the cardiologist who are the doctors, main doctors, right? So this is the paramedical course. So the next paramedical course is BSc PT. PT is the perfusion technology. And these graduates are called as perfusionists. And the role of them in what these people will do is, they know how to run the machinery that assist patient's own respiratory and circulatory system. So the keeping the respiratory and circulatory systems are in the body, right? So respiratory or circulatory systems in the body is most important during an operations or other medical procedures that are happening. So during this process, keeping the proper respiratory and circulatory systems in the body is most important, and for this perfusionist becomes handy. These perfusionists are responsible for medical procedures, responsible for the selection, setup, and operations of the heart-lung machines. So heart-lung machines, which will maintain the circulatory system, will be taken care by this perfusionist during the operations or a medical process that will be taken care by doctors, right? So these people will be helping the doctors in maintaining the circulatory systems or the respiratory systems. So with the help of the machines, they do, and for that they are the technicians. Next is another technical course, so that is BSc in RC, that is respiratory care, and they are called as respiratory therapist. This is they are perfusionist, PT is perfusionist, and RC is a respiratory therapist. So here, scientific applications of technology in order to assist in the diagnosis, the treatment, and management and care of the patients with the cardiopulmonary and associated disease. So the people who are having cardio and pulmonary problems, right, they will be have to be taken care, and for this, these people, respiratory assist therapist will help the doctors so that they can understand the person properly, the patients properly, and for that, these the respiratory therapists are the services of them are being utilized. So these are all the three paramedical courses, right? Of course, this is a representative by scale for the people with this technical knowledge, right? So they are the technicians. So these are the three other medical courses, and have supplementary information for the paramedical courses that I have just discussed, from the heart to lungs, right? From cardiac care to perfusionist, right? Cardiac care, for this, these are the job probabilities of career options which are there in Australia for the cardiac care technologist, and also this is for the cardiac care technologist or vascular technologist in US, right? So these are the opportunities for the people who have with those degrees, that is BSc in CCT. And this is the pay scale for the pay or salary for the people with the cardiac BSc in the CCT. So this is about the possibilities for the people. These are the possibilities for the career options, and this is the pay scale link. And for the perfusionist, the what are the career prospects, what are the possibilities that can be obtained from this link, and this will tell you about how long it will take to become a perfusionist. So this will give a more light into the perfusion technology and also perfusionist role, right? And this will tell you about the salary that you can expect after becoming a perfusionist, right? So these are the possibilities, the salary returns which you will be getting after completing PT, BSc in PT. And this is an instrument used for the cardiac care, right? These are the possibilities in the cardiovascular perfusionist. So this is another link which will give an insight into the cardiovascular treatment and the usage of services of them and their career prospects. So this is in US. This is for the people who would like to continue pursue their career in US, and this will tell more about this cardiovascular processes, the treatment or role of this cardiovascular and perfusionists. This is how the perfusionist role is. These are the instruments which can keep the circulatory system in intact. So this is a heart lung machine that will keep the circulations in intact, right? So this is a representation of it. So this is about respiratory care journal. So that will give more details into this, into the career and the role of them, carried role taken care by them, and this will tell you about the opportunities which are there for this respiratory care personnel. And this will give this link will give the salaries for the respiratory therapist or respiratory care personnel. So these are the three paramedical courses that you can think of after 12th with science as the stream. So there are some more paramedical courses that you can think of, and that is after science in 11th and 12th with the PCMB as a combination. So BSc in OTT, that is Operation Theatre Technologists. They are the assistants or technicians who will be helping the surgeons or the doctors, right? So they are called as OT assistants, Operation Theatre Assistants. What they do is they look after the drugs required for surgery, anesthetic gases and drapes, and all the linen and other sterilization equipments that are required for the surgery. So they are the people who will be helping the surgeon in keeping the person. So the anesthesia is important to make him unconscious, right? What are the requirements that are required there, and what are the linens, the cloths that are required, and what are the sterilizing instruments that are very essential for the surgery, right? For that, they need to know about the process which is happening and what are the requirements that is needed at the time of surgery, because when they are doing the operation, the surgeon need to be keep his head cool, and the assistant should be well versed with the procedure, and for that this is the course. So this will be about Operation Theatre Technologists. So they are called as OT assistants. So the salary will vary between 2 to 6 lakhs, and again depends upon the place where you are working and the services of the person that will be rendered to the hospital. Next is MSc, BSc in MLT, Medical Lab Technologist. So this is what the course for the laboratory technician to test all the specimens which will come there for to diagnose the disease, right? So these people place a very, very important role. So if you are more skilled, then your value will be more here, right? So laboratory technician plays a very important role in diagnosis and also in therapeutic in the treatment. So for that, for the treatment, diagnosis is more important, and these people will do the diagnosis, the treatment, and the prevention of diseases through the use of the clinical laboratory tests. So they are basically diagnosing the samples, right? So they will tell you, they give the feedback about the quality of the specimen which has, they have received. They diagnose what are the problems with that. They will give by comparing that with the standard expected values, right? So they compare the values they got with the expected value or standard values. By that, the diagnosis will be possible, and for that, BSc in MLT, that is Medical Lab Technologist, plays a very important role. So here you can start your own lab so to test the samples, right? So that's also possible, or else you can work in the hospitals. So they vary between 1 to 6 lakhs. So there is a variation that depends upon a variation salary depends upon the person's credentials. Next course is BSc in Radiography or BSc in Medical Imaging and Technology. This is one of the important paramedical course, right? They are called as a radiologic technologist. So they are, they, what the role of them is, the diagnosis of a disease and ailments related to the internal and hidden parts of the body. So with the use of x-rays and also CT scans or MRI and ultrasound for radiography, create images of the body for parts for the clinical purposes. So it will create the images. So creating the proper image is very important, because some of the parts are not visible, they are hidden. So they, with the help of either CT scans or MRI or ultrasound, right, x-ray, right? So MRI will come at the end, right? So x-rays, CT scans, and ultrasounds and the CT scans will help to diagnose, for the diagnosis, right? So this role of this technologist, radiological technologist, is very, very important in the diagnosis of some of the important ailments. So for that, these technicians becomes more handy to the doctors and also to the patients, right? So the salary will vary between 3 to 10 lakh. So again, depends upon credibility of the person, right? Taking the medical imaging is also very, very important, right? So that is one of the important aspects, right? That again depends upon the skill of the person. So these are all the three more paramedical courses that you can think of after 12th. Now, supplementary information for the previous slide, where in which studied some of the paramedical courses, right? This link will tell you about the different courses which are there in the Rajiv Gandhi Medical University, right, in the Karnataka. It's a medical university for the people, right? So here you get the courses which are there, both paramedical courses and also other courses which are there in the Rajiv Gandhi Medical University. So this is the link for it. And also for the medical lab technicians, right, what are the possibilities and what in the basic medical, that you can get it from this link, right? And this also tell you about the pay scale, pay salary for the medical lab technicians, and will wish to work in other technical laboratories, right? And so this is how they do that, and this also gives the salary or the salary for the person who have done the BSc in medical lab technology. And then this will give about the radiography. This is about the radiography, how they take the images of the hidden parts, right, the parts which are not easily visible, right, with the help of MRI, right, they can take it up. And this will give the scope for the BSc radio radiology. This link will tell you about what are the scopes for the BSc radiology. And there is this also, this YouTube will tell you more about these courses, right? So you can watch this video to get more information. And this will tell you the difference between the BSc radiology and also the radiology the people with MBBS will do after the MBBS, right? So this link will tell you about that. So these are all the additional informations which can help you to make you for a make you to take the decision for your course either after 10th or 12th. Now let us see some of the allied medical professions. This is after science with the PCMB graduation. PCMB as the combination. So Bachelor of Optometry. So this is ophthalmology, right? This is the Bachelor of Optometry, and these people will become optometrists, right? So what they people will do is examination, diagnosis and treatment, and management of diseases and disorders of the visual systems, but they cannot do the surgery. So that is the major difference between ophthalmologist and this optometrist. So the optometrist can prescribe the lens for the person who is having a problem with the vision problem. So they can prescribe the lens, and also some of the ailments can be treated with the help of these people. They basically will treat the person who is having a vision problem. So basically they prescribe the lens for them. So that is the role of this optometrician or optometrist. So salary vary between 3 to 6 lakh, and this is one of the best profession if you want to help in the medical field. If you want to work in the medical field, this is one of the best medicine course rather. Next is BSc in food technology, and they are called as food technologists. Food processing, food packaging, nutrition, storage and making of the nutritious food. So that is the role of the BSc food technologist, and it is an allied course for the health of a person, to maintain the health of the persons, and also it involves food processing, food packaging, and this is one of the important course for the students who would like to pursue the career, right? And in fact, you can be an independent self-employed personnel if you do this, right? Because food processing can be done on your own, right? And you can become a very wonderful marketing you can sell this product which is more nutritious. You can make a nutritious food and sell it. Next is BSc in nutrition and dietetics, and they are called as dietitians. They explore the role of it, them is exploring the healthier dietary modifications and enhancing the quality of life. So they take care of the diet of a patient or a person rather, right, and helps enhance the quality of the life. So you can be you can practice as a private dietitian, or you can help the medical profession, right, by becoming a dietitian and maintaining the health of the person and also enhance the quality of life. So this is the role of a BSc in nutrition and dietetics degree. and this is one of the important course. So nowadays this course is picking up momentum in most of the urban areas and also to a certain extent the small towns. So this is one of the good profession for the students who would like to help the medical field. So the salary will vary between 1.5 to 3 lakh per annum. Next is BSc in Forensic Science. This is altogether different, right? So here you will become a forensic expert. So your role is investigation of crimes, analyze the evidences found at the crime scenes. So analyzing the evidence is most important. By finding out the evidences that you get at the crime scene, you will become a forensic expert. You can predict these are the possibilities, these are the things which have happened by so knowing the facts that are evidences that are been seen at the crime scene. So this is one of the important course. There are very less colleges are offering this forensic sciences. So in criminology, this is very very important aspect. So that is finding, investigating the crimes and analyzing it. So this is one of the important career that you can choose. Salary vary between 3 to 5 lakh. So these are all the other courses that you can take up after 10th if you take science as a combination, and after 12th these are the combined possibilities. So here you can plan your career by knowing what are the possibilities that you can do after 12th. So those who students after 10th, if you want to pursue the field in this, you choose science and PCMB as a combination. So PCMB is the best combination for the students who would like to help in the medicinal and allied field. Let me give you some more information on the paramedical additional courses that I have told, from eye to eye for an eye. So from ophthalmology, optometrician to criminology, right? So here this is the role of optometrician, right? You can what are the possibilities and what are the pay scale, salary for the optometrist that can be obtained from this link. This link will give an idea about remunerations that can be expected by optometrician. And also this will tell you about the possibilities of optometrician in Australia. So these are the job prospects in Australia. And this video will tell you more about this ophthalmology. And this also gives more information about ophthalmologists in India, right, and the career jobs and what are the positions that they can expect. So that can be obtained from this link. So this is for the optometricians. So next, for the food technologist. So if you, this will give whether you have chosen the food technology is a good career option to choose after the 12th. So that can be obtained, and this is the link which will tell you about the course that for future of this food technology course. And this will tell you about, this link will tell you about the salary and the remuneration aspects of for the food technologist. So this link will tell you about that, and this also tell you about the food technologist as a career in India. So this link will have more information for the food technologist. So this is a YouTube video, right? So this will give more information and detailed information on the food technology. And this is link will tell you about the salary that you can expect in India after doing this food technology course. The next is the nutrition and dietetics. So for the dietitian, right, in UK, what are the career aspects and what can I do with my degree in nutrition in UK, and that you can get it here, right? So this link will tell you about it, and this will tell you about the education aspects and what are the career aspects for this nutrition is or dietetics, the dietitians. So next, this video again will give more information on the dietitians or nutritionists. So this about the forensic science and the criminology. So they are the people who help in the analyzing the crime. So this is this link will tell you whether the what is the scope for the forensic science in India. Is it good to do BSc in forensic science in India, right? So that this link will tell you about the selection of this forensic science as a career after 12th, or as a course as a after 12th, and career for the person, for an individual. And this will tell you about the scope of this forensic science, and this is a really wonderful career indeed. Discover your career options in forensic sciences. These links will tell you about the career options, right? So these are all the tools, these are all the links which can help you to make a proper decision of for either optometrician, a food technologist, a dietitians, or forensic experts. So these are all the supplementary informations. I hope these informations which I have given for the paramedical courses and medical courses, both conventional and other allied treatments, right, or non-conventional treatments, will be useful in making a proper selection for your life and career. Hi friends, I hope you like this video. The information provided on paramedical science, alternative medicine and medicine will be useful, and it will help you in making a decision for your life. And my previous video was on that is part one video, the career guidance part one. It was on engineering, basic science, veterinary science, medical, agriculture sciences, and all those were covered on part one. If you have not watched, please watch that. And the next will be for the students who wish to pursue their career in the commerce section, right? So before that, please like this video and share with your friends, relatives, and also your students if you have. And the next video, as I mentioned, it is on the commerce. If you want to pursue your career in commerce, after 10th you can take commerce stream, and then the what are the career opportunities which are there has been covered here in this, what career options are there after 12th or second PUC if commerce stream is taken after 10th. So this information, this has wonderful information. So there is a certification program called the financial planning, and this has been recognized in 23 countries. You can become a business administrator, right? So by doing BCA and then MBA. Then you can also become a chartered accountant by doing this chartered accountancy, or you can become a company secretary or custom management accountant, or you can get into the banking sector, you can be a marketing manager or marketing personnel, or you can also work in the stock market as a stock broker, and you can also become a software developer by doing this computer application course, like BCA and then MCA, right? So these are all the wonderful opportunities, and many people who have completed this course have been appointed immediately, right? So those opportunities are there. So utilize that by watching this, you get to know about it, and wish you will have a wonderful career, right? I request you to subscribe to my channel, and for this there is no fee involved. Please do subscribe. Thank you very much, and have a wonderful career. Do make the decision in a right way for a better future.